Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and today Apple released iOS 15.4 Beta 5. This was a bit of a surprise as we thought we'd probably see a release candidate instead, but now we have Beta 5. And this came in at a fairly small 421.5 megabytes, that's on my iPhone 13 Pro Max, and it was about the same size on all the devices in this video, from the iPhone 11, 6S Plus, iPhone 10, and iPad Pro. Now, along with iOS 15.4 Beta 5, Apple also released iPadOS 15.4 Beta 5, watchOS 8.5 Beta 5, along with tvOS 15.4 Beta 5, HomePodOS 15.4 Beta 5, and macOS 12.3 Beta 5. All of those are available now to developers, and hopefully soon, by the time you're watching this video, to public beta testers as well. Last week, it came out a little bit after I posted the video. Now let's take a look at the build number and talk about what's new. So we'll go to Settings, then General, then About. You can see the build number is 19E5241A, and this is a slightly newer version, even though it has an A at the end of it. So they've updated it a little bit, and I was quite surprised that we didn't have an RC or release candidate instead. I was pretty convinced we'd have one, but according to Mark Gurman on Twitter, he's actually said that this is the last version of iOS 15.4 before the public release. However, I'd be very surprised if they didn't release a release candidate first before that final release. Now, as far as new changes and updates, well, as far as a new modem update, there is no new modem update, at least on the 13 Pro Max. From Beta 4 to Beta 5, we have the same version number, 1.59.03. So with the 13 Pro Max, if you were having issues with it switching between 5G and 4G or other connectivity issues, I would not expect those to be resolved in this update. Now, as far as other things that are changed or new, the first new thing has to do with a new notification splash screen. Apple has been updating this throughout the OS with 15.4, and the first time I went into Apple Wallet, I saw this. So you can see here we have a new icon for notifications, and it says, get updates on your purchases. Receive transaction notifications whenever your cards are used with Apple Pay. You can turn on notifications or not now. You're going to see more and more of these new style notifications with little splash screens the first time you go into a lot of apps with 15.4. Now, the next thing I saw that was new is the first time I went into the Home app and set it up on a different device, I went in here and I saw this new notification. I've seen this in the code before, but I've never seen it actually appear on the display. And it says, Home would like to send you critical alerts. Critical alerts always play a sound and appear on your lock screen, even if your iPhone is muted or Do Not Disturb is on. Manage critical alerts in settings, and you can allow that or not allow that. So that's something new that I saw that may have been there before, but I really didn't see anything other than that. Aside from that, the only other new thing that I was able to find is a new Siri notification, or Siri when you ask it about the March event that we were waiting for invites for. So if we hold down the Siri button or power sleep wake button and say, what will be announced at the Apple event? You can see now it's saying you can get all the details about Apple events on apple.com. However, when I asked this a bit earlier, I actually posted this on Twitter as well, it says, you can't hurry news. No, you'll just have to wait. And so it was saying something different. Some people are seeing this. Sometimes you have to ask multiple times and it will pop up. But it looks like we could have an Apple event very soon, although we didn't see invites today as we expected. Now, in 15.4, there are a ton of changes. There are 35 features and changes overall that I counted since the first beta, such as Face ID with a mask, 37 new emoji, and much, much more. However, in Beta 5, we're going to see less and less changes since this is getting closer and closer to a final release. With the A at the end of the build number, it typically means we're getting closer to a final build, and it will be released to the public fairly soon. But as far as this particular update, I'm not seeing anything else. I went through a ton of different apps, settings, and more. However, that doesn't mean there's not some small changes here and there, but it is seemingly more refined. Now, this time around, Apple has not mentioned any specific issues that have been resolved in their notes. So within the notes, they haven't mentioned anything. So they didn't mention anything about the storage bug being resolved, although it seems to be resolved since Beta 3. Many of you have messaged me saying that it's been resolved, and if I test it on the iPhone 11 or the 13 Pro Max, you'll see it takes a moment to load, but it's popping up properly every time. The 11 loaded much faster with this storage update. But I do have a lot more things on the 13 Pro Max, but you can see it updated and then it just filled in the system data. So it looks like it's working properly on everyone's device. At least that's what most people have told me. Now, Apple has also mentioned 12 issues that are still known. So there's 12 known issues mentioned in the notes, but they're all the same as beta 4, such as signing into an iPad is limited to apps in this beta, and the health app crashes when you attempt to onboard the blood oxygen feature from within the app. So if you're in health trying to set up blood oxygen, sometimes it can cause a problem and just not work properly. But there's no mention at all of the pink screen bug, where it would actually reboot and sort of present you with a pink or purple display. However, most people say that's been resolved and they haven't seen that since about beta 2. But some people are seeing that on iOS 15.3.1 still. There's also no mention that they've resolved the issue with the music bug, where you're streaming music and in turn it causes additional issues, where it would use more processing power and then in turn cause worse battery life or excessive battery drain. I haven't seen that at all. Apple has not mentioned it. However, it does seem to be performing better as far as that goes, but there's still maybe a few bugs here and there in this. Now, as far as when to expect iOS 15.4 RC and the release, well, since this is beta 5 and we're on the A build number, we could see an RC within a few days and still have that Apple event invite maybe go out tomorrow where we would have that event on the 8th. That could change at any time given everything that's going on around the world. Apple can actually make this very fluid and move it around to whatever works best. So maybe we'll see it then, maybe we'll see it a little bit later. But last year with iOS 14.5, we had as many as 8 betas and then a release candidate and then a final release in April. We could see any sort of similar scenario coming up with that, and maybe we'll see that released in a week, or it could be a few weeks at this point, given what's going on. Apple could maybe change this a little bit. But either way, we can expect an update fairly soon that seems more and more stable as I've been using it. As far as overall battery life does seem to be getting a little bit better. There are some odd bugs here and there, but if we go into battery health on my 13 Pro Max is at 100%, and I will be mentioning about battery life and what it's like after using it for a few days, since using it just for another hour or so doesn't really give us a full picture of what's going on. So be sure to check back for the follow-up. But with beta 4, you can see I had 4 hours and 30 minutes of screen on time, 5 hours and 49 minutes of screen off time, and used about 60% of my battery. This wasn't that great, and music was using background activity despite me not using it all in the background. So there's definitely some odd issues there, and the same is true with the iPad. With iPadOS 15.4, I've had some very mixed battery life. It's been very odd showing me times that it was charged when it wasn't actually charged. However, this is accurate now, so maybe they've resolved that, where it says last charged to 84% an hour ago. That's when I was installing the update. And I was getting excessive screen off time. So you'll see here I have 5 hours and 40 minutes of screen off time yesterday. I didn't use it at all with the screen off. With the screen on, I used it for about an hour and a half, watching YouTube, doing messages and things like that. But I haven't found anything that's causing this screen off time. So I'm not sure what that is and haven't figured that out yet. Hopefully it's resolved in this update, but it will take a few days to notice. As far as performance overall, performance seems okay, but upon initial boot of the 6S Plus, it was quite slow and sluggish. You'll see now it's loading music. I opened this for the first time. We'll give it just a moment here. There we go. And it's okay, but it's scrolling okay this time, but it's been quite sluggish the first time I booted it up. It took quite a while to finish background processing, and you could see right there it actually stuttered for a moment. So there's some issues going on here or there. As far as frame rates and games and things, I did want to share Minecraft, but I would love to hear from you what would be a better example other than Minecraft, maybe something that you use more and more. However, my kids play Minecraft every day, and so do a lot of other people I know, so I thought it was a good example. So we'll give it just a moment to load and see what the frame rates are like. Now, it did take about 30 seconds or more to actually load this time around, so that was a bit slow, but the frame rate is nice and smooth, and I'm not seeing any issues there. So games should function fine, and as far as the overall heat of the device is a little bit warm, the 6S Plus since loading that game, but it's not excessively hot. I know quite a few people worry about that, and Apple is quite aggressive at actually managing that, but even after installing the update, it felt a little bit warm, which is typical, but not overly hot. So I wouldn't really worry about that too much with this update. It seems much better than it has in the past. As far as benchmarks, I've been sharing those more in the follow-up video, but I did run an initial benchmark on the 13 Pro Max, and you'll see it scored 1,737 for single core, 4,693 for multi-core. This is actually slightly better in some ways than what I ran the other day, where we had a little bit higher for multi-core, but a little bit lower for single core. So it's doing quite well. It's within 100 either way and should perform as you would expect. And that leads me to, should you install iOS 15.4 beta 5? Well, you've probably heard me say this many times before. If you're a beta tester, definitely install it already so you can find any additional bugs, report your feedback, and make sure that you fill out that feedback form so Apple can fix any additional issues that might be in it. However, if you're wanting to try this out and you're not on the betas already, as long as you're realizing that it might have some bugs here and there, it's definitely something you could try out. Just make sure you have a backup. We're in the final stages of iOS 15.4 and it should be fairly stable, but again, there could be bugs. So if you're trying to solve an issue from 15.3.1 or an earlier build, I would hold off until the final release, since you're bound to have at least a bug here and there, typically with betas. So if you're looking for better battery life or something like that, wait for the final release and go from there. So that's it for everything in iOS 15.4 beta 5. Of course, if I find anything else, I'll be sure to share that in a video later this week, and be sure to check back for the follow-up on the weekend where I cover everything from performance to battery life, additional bugs and things they've fixed, and more. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.